Get ready to match the star. Edward Asner, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Julie London, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rivers!
Nice to see all of your beautiful bodies. Everybody okay over here?
Right.
Our regulars, Brett, Charles, and Richard, and our semi-regular with the dollar sign on her front there.
Save your pennies, honey.
Okay, what do I get? No, don't answer that. Well, listen, old bean, we've worked together before, but you've never been here.
No,
so
I've never been here.
We have a little tradition here.
Thanks for having me.
That when we have new people, we give them a special welcome. You got it. Okay. Now, what do you say?
Did you do the same thing to him?
No, she did it for him. She carries it, takes care of the upstairs.
Remember when we talked about New York versus London and I said I preferred London?
Yes.
This is what I was talking about.
Julie London, right toe. Okay, now let's say hello to Dorothy Seidel and Terry Richardson. Dorothy's our current champ. She's won 3 games, has a grand total of $7,000 even, which is pretty good here. Listen, you bought a Poochie since we last saw each other. You're starting to spend the money already and we haven't even sent it to you.
I got carried away.
Well, good for you. And she's being challenged by Terry here. We've had our first round questions, and actually this is kind of a tight game here. It's 4-3 in Terry's favor. We'll go to the second and final round in a moment or so, but right now we want you to pay strict attention to this.
Still sitting in.
Now, I push this button here and reveal our second round questions. Final round, Terry, it's up to you to make your decision here, A or B.
I'll try B this time.
B it is. 2 people play only. Only 2. Richard and Fanny are the only 2 who will participate in this because he matched 4 of the celebrities during the first round.
Well, who matched here when I was
Was sitting there played the first round, Betty White.
Well, isn't she a smart one?
She is smart, yes. Here it is. The doctor said to Fat Phil, I've got a surefire way for you to lose 20 pounds of ugly fat. I'm going to cut off your blank. Surefire way for you to lose 20 pounds of ugly fat. I'm going to cut off your blank.
Okay. I suppose now Julie London's here this week, you won't even notice Fanny and I at all.
No. No, I will be up there sometime during the course of the week to kiss your lips, just as I did hers.
I know that you're just going to be hugging.
She's a good kisser. Are you ready, Fanny?
Yes.
Okay, Terry Richardson. The doctor said to Fat Phil, I've got a surefire way for you to lose 20 pounds of ugly fat. I'm going to cut off your blank.
Your head.
Your head. All right. You're up first.
Yeah, Terry, he wouldn't care whether he was fat or thin if his head was cut off. I thought he'd take a little slice of his derriere.
It's the other end.
Get a little behind
right.
in his work.
Yes. All right. Now, what did you say, Fanny?
I knew Fat Phil.
You did know Fat Phil?
He was awfully cute, but I thought that he should have his wife's head cut off.
Head and wife's head does not match. So now, Dorothy, here's what you have to do. You have to match 1 celebrity to tie, 2 to win. You ready? This is it. Listen carefully. Only 3 people play.
The top row.
The top row plays.
The silly the pretties are playing.
Yeah, the pretties are playing.
No, we're not. The top row's playing.
Here it is. At the restaurant, Jerry said to the waiter, he said, about this soup, aren't these matzo balls a little heavy? And the waiter said, to tell you the truth, we ran out of matzo balls. You're eating blank balls.
Golly, you have white teeth.
Thank you.
All right. Ed? Ed is hurrying. Ed is poking along.
Okay.
All right, now he's finished, and we'll come over here to Dorothy Seibel. At the restaurant, Jerry said to the waiter, "About this soup, aren't these matzo balls a little heavy?" And the waiter said, "To tell you the truth, we ran out of matzo balls. You're eating blank balls."
Golf balls.
Golf balls.
I think that's pretty good.
By Jove, I think that lady came up with a rather acceptable answer, don't you, Ed? What?
It's,
I wasn't playing, but
that's right. You have golf balls there,
yeah,
okay.
Well, bourbon.
Yeah. Ed?
Well, suffering the, the newness of all this, I feel like a virgin again.
Oh, really? I don't care to hear about it.
I was a little, well, you were there. You don't have to. No, I'm much younger. Anyway, I suffered from panic, and I, put
just
down
wrote an
inane answer.
Well, I'm glad you did something. Snowballs. Okay.
Is that wrong?
To tell you the truth, you're eating snowballs.
Yes. Oh, yes, right. That is about as wrong as you can get.
Leave him alone. He's a new kid on the block.
You mind your own beeswax here now. I once made matzo balls, and I literally threw them into the sink, and they went like that, and they bounced. That's true. They're very hard to make. I said golf balls.
Golf balls. Now we have a tie score. Charles?
And you... she used a broth from her homemade soup to polish her car. She's fabulous. I'm sorry, sir. Golf balls.
Golf balls wins the game. Anyway, all right, you stand by for a moment. You've done it again. Terry, we're going to say goodbye to you, but we've got gifts for you. Together with our thanks for being with us here on Match Game 75. Terry Richardson, ladies and gentlemen. Well, he's spinning off. We'll spin this message for you, and then you hurry back and see how she does with the big money here. Once again, we are up here with Dorothy. It's your fourth time, right?
I don't remember.
Yes, it is. Your fourth time, Dorothy. You have $7,100. Once again, you're going to try for over $10,000, and I guess we ought to begin. Stand on that hunk of adhesive tape there, and everything will be okay. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank breath. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250. The bottom one gets you $100. And whom do you call on for an assist over here?
Charles.
What do you say, Charles?
I got a couple, but I think...
Okay. All right, that's one.
Brett?
What about out of breath?
Out of breath, that's two.
And Richard?
Came to me third, eh? Well, don't hold your breath.
Don't hold your breath is one, bad breath is two, and out of breath is three. You want one of those?
Yes, I would like to go with Charles' answer, bad breath.
Bad breath? I think you're letting the audience influence you, aren't you?
Sometimes.
Only in America could bad breath get a round of applause.
That's right. It's a strange situation.
It's really shattered you, doesn't it?
Let's see if we can find bad breath. Blah. I hate this whole routine. May we see the $100 response? Sweet breath. Yeah.
Why
can't that give you more
nothing
money?
Nothing for sweet breath.
They don't
breath
applaud
here.
Sweet breath. Bad breath is what they applaud. Weirdos. All right, here's a $250 response. Deep breath. They don't even applaud that.
Oh, the
guy's gasping. Takes a deep breath there. I tell you, I'm really going to be disappointed in America and our studio audiences and everybody if their bad breath pays off $500. I'm really going to be terribly disappointed there. Oh, I want you to have the money, but I just, I don't, all right, go ahead, slide it, Earl. I'd say you won the money. Congratulations. Now you got $7,600 there. Okay, now you're going to play for $5,000. Get the Kleenex out. Yeah. This girl is a weeper. First weeper we've had. She wins the money and she starts bawling like a baby, but we're very happy for her. She got $7,600. Now, to collect the $5,000, which will give you over $12,000, you got to match one of the celebrities exactly. Which one would it be?
Richard.
All right.
I've been through all her tears with her.
In anticipation of winning the money, she's already crying there. All right. You stand on the adhesive tape.
She's having a nervous breakdown?
No. Just face me, if you would, please, Dorothy. Richard, here it is. It's worth $5,000. Nervous blank. Okay, he's finished. Now, Dorothy, what answer do you want to give us? What you think will match his nervous blank?
Well, I really have to say breakdown.
Why? Are you close to one, are you?
Yes.
Are you close to one?
Close.
This poor girl thinks she's ready to have a nervous breakdown. You're not going to have a nervous breakdown on camera. Wouldn't that be a first, friend? Say, all right, she says nervous will breakdown. We'll match it for $5,000. What do you say, Richard?
Oh. I'm sorry, that didn't even occur.
It didn't?
You didn't occur to you?
Yeah. Nervous breath, I thought. Maybe I'll cry this time. Nervous is a cat.
Nervous breakdown, she
nervous
said.
Nervous is a cat in a room full of rocking chairs. It's enough to give you a break.
Total of $12,600, and we're all very happy for her. Now let's meet Edith Sprinkle. Here comes Edith Sprinkle. Wait a minute. All right, Edith, let's bring Edith Sprinkle in. I'll get to you in a second there, Joe. What do you have to say, Joe?
I just have to say I think it's shocking.
What?
Because when she came on the show about a year and a half ago,
yes,
as a poor woman, she said her nieces and nephews were staying home to watch her.
Yes.
They have now all failed out of class.
Yes.
But they don't care because they go around the city saying, our aunt's a very rich lady.
Let's say hello to Edith.
Let's say hello to Edith Sprinkle. Hello, Edith.
Hello.
Edith, you're very happy for her, right?
Oh, excited.
Good. Where are you from, Edith?
Miami, Florida.
Yep. You live here now?
No.
You live in Miami?
Well, I come back and forth to see my family here all
I
the
see.
Time, as much as I can.
Yes. And anything else you want to tell us about yourself?
Yes, I'm a married lady and have been for 30-odd years.
Yep.
To a marvelous man. I have two wonderful, wonderful children. One of them's out there.
Good.
And one of them teaches at Johns Hopkins in Baltimore.
Mm-hmm.
And life is beautiful. I'm happy to be here. That's
We're happy to have you, Edith Sprinkle. Good luck to you. I'll push the button, reveal our first round questions. Dorothy, you ready? Is there something we need to be? Want some water? This is not Road of Life, Dorothy. This is Match Game.
I'm smiling.
All right. She's smiling too.
A sip of something. There's your winning card.
Right, thank you.
It says on there, you'll soon have enough to support me. Take a sip. I must have it back, though.
Yeah, take a sip of that. That'll be good for you.
Thank you.
Where's the bang on the drum there, the way Jackie Gleason always had? Boy, all right. Thank you very much. Now, I ask Edith Sprinkle to make her selection here, A or B.
Well, my granddaughter said take A.
Is that what she said? How old
Why
is she?
Why take B, then?
She's 8.
She's 8. All right, everybody plays. This is it. Murray said Dr. Soul, the foot doctor, is really strange. After... Stay out of show business. Dr. Soul, the foot doctor, is really strange. After he removed my corn, he blanked it.
I hate that
question. So do I.
Just the kind of question I loathe and detest.
After he removed my corn, he blanked it.
First round's finished.
We're all finished now.
Splendid. All right. Ed's ready here. And I guess we're ready up there, too. Okay, here we go. Yes. Fanny, did you put it in the slot?
Yes, right. She was the first one.
Not quite get in there. All right, Edith, here we are, up to you. Murray said, Dr. Soule, the foot doctor, is really strange. After he removed my corn, he blanked it.
Pickled it.
He pickled it. Yeah. I think our doctor was a little stranger than that, as you will find out when we call upon our celebrated guest. Edward?
Well, the cost of meat these days and the...
I see what you're leading up
high
to.
High cost of feed grains, yeah. I felt that the doctor wasn't as strange as...
Oh, he planted it. Oh. All right, that's an interesting answer. Sure. Hadn't occurred to me. That's okay. Brett, what did you say?
I'm going quickly by this answer because I strongly resent this question, but I said he boiled it naked.
Boiled it naked. Well, the audience thinks that's the popular favorite, according to their applause and yaying. Charles?
He almost popped it. No, he ate it with butter and salt.
Today's program is really revolting. All right. Give us a good answer.
Well, I'm just as revolting as everybody else.
Revolting Julie London said he ate it. No, ate is the answer. Yeah, ate is the answer. If you got a weird foot doctor, he'd eat that corn after he cut it off there. What'd you say?
I was going to say that he sold it to the Jolly Green Giant. Edith, it's no good going like this because I never heard of pickled corn. Otherwise, I would have written it. I wrote eight. I thought that's what you would say.
So as a matter of fact, there he is. You can buy those tiny ears of corn in quart jars, and they are pickled. Yes. You've had those, haven't you?
I honestly have never heard of that, but I would have written it either.
But it's a rather esoteric dish. What did you say, Fanny?
I say Ed Asner is the cutest thing since Santa Claus.
That's right.
But I said eight, unfortunately.
Eight is.
Yeah.
Right. Well, if you said eight, you did well. You would have done very well with that.
Your brilliance is stunning.
Sybil, we'll have a question for you in a moment, and we'll give you a chance to get it together while we do a little business with America. This is it.
See?
Now, we go, Dorothy, this is all yours, your first round question. Everybody plays. Here it is. When Harvey was arrested, the police gave him the world's most horrible torture. Aww. They locked him in a room with blank. The world's most horrible torture. They locked him in a room with blank. It's a first rounder. You know how they are.
We'll
just put something down and away we go. Nothing there yet.
You're a complete blank.
That's the name of the game. Complete blank. Listen, if I haven't said it before, I want to say it right now. The official, I think you're absolutely marvelous on the Mary Tyler Moore Show. Isn't he? Yeah. You are some actor. He's so shy, isn't he? Yeah.
You know why he's happy?
Why?
He's just got the oil drilling rights to Jack Lord's hair.
I'd like to get the rights to Jack Lord's hair, period.
Okay.
Dorothy, we're ready for you. When Harvey was arrested, the police gave him the world's most horrible torture. They locked him in a room with blank.
I blanked too.
You drew a blank too?
Yeah, well...
Well, these are a little hard.
It's...
She had a hard one, you've got a hard one. We try and give you each ones of equal degree of difficulty. What do you say?
With, oh, this is terrible. With Nixon?
With who?
Nixon.
With Nixon. Well, that would be good or bad, depending on your viewpoint. Edward?
You know, I'm...
She drew a blank. Now, this is a difficult question, I gotta admit.
I feel so rotten, and the way you've you know, your previous remark to me and all
yes,
that.
Yes, and I've been so gracious to you, and so kind. And you're letting us down.
Please, no, just please write this off as a case of nerves on my part.
Oh, you rascal! He said me. What would be so bad about that?
Okay.
Shall I tell them? Oh, no, I better.
No, better not there. Now, what do you say?
Well, darling, I couldn't think. I went totally blank like Dorothy, but I loved her answer. I thought that was a terrific. I'm on her side. I said about the seven dwarfs drunk.
The seven dwarfs drunk.
I mean, that...
That'd drive you right up the wall, wouldn't it?
You'd go crazy.
Right. Hello, Charles.
I'm with San Clemente now, area code. Yes. I understand. The nieces and nephews will be put in prison, sir.
Yes.
Just all of them. He suggests that it be Howard Cosell.
Howard Cosell.
That would really hurt.
Okay. My dear, you are up. Go.
I don't really mean this.
Who are you kidding?
I just said it, but I don't really mean it. I said Brett.
Brett.
I really mean this, Brett.
We're looking for the answer, Nixon. What do you say?
I say he was locked in the room with his mother-in-law.
Mother-in-law. Okay, no score at the end of round one. Now we've got this message for you.
Brett.
Gene Mabern here. Goodbye.